This is always a heavy time of year for me. Seems like always the everything contracts. We go inside, gets darker, politics becomes pressurized. We just have this Rittenhouse verdict, but every year it seems like the autumn. Recent years it's all year round, but in the autumn it gets very much more intense. So, Thanksgiving, what to do, because there's a lot of whitewash history that happens with the convention of Thanksgiving, and it seems like we eat and drink and entertain ourselves in gluttony and don't actually give thanks and don't actually recognize the part of society that we're playing by celebrating Thanksgiving in this consumption, consumerist, and ignoring the history of white supremacy of our country and what that kind of what erases by having Thanksgiving. Because, like, in my generation, and I'm sure kids are still doing this, their classroom activity sometimes is like coloring feathers and making like a headband. And you're like, oh, it's Thanksgiving, like feathers in a turkey. Like, that's our culture. And it's sad. So I put a post up recently that was like, what can I do instead of just not doing anything and like being a negative? What can I do as an inverse to Thanksgiving? And what do we call it? And then a good friend Katarina came up with this term, Thanksgiving, or we came up with it together. And what feels right for me is that I'm going on a trip to visit my family. And I'm not going to fast on Thanksgiving because that feels like it'll be distracting from being present, I think. If like the discussion is all about why are you fasting? Blah, blah, blah. I don't know that I want to have that conversation all day. Some people probably want to. But so I'm going to fast the 3 days before and then just like use moderation on Thanksgiving and try to be really present with the flavors and the people and the experience. And so this kind of like deprivation before and then hopefully having a really great Thanksgiving. Because that's the thing, if rituals are important, holidays are important, they're like our cultural currency of like we have to have a shared identity. And so Christmas, Thanksgiving, Easter for some folks, like July 4th, right? America's birthday. We need holidays, we need rituals. And the ones we have kind of suck a lot. And but they're rooted in a right, a harvest festival, in like a necessity of our people and our time and our ancestors. So so I'm just gonna fast before Thanksgiving. And we'll see how it goes. And I wanted to share that because maybe you are looking for an alternative way of acknowledging the harvest and the change of seasons and family and life. So, yeah, I'm really excited because I know when I go home, I tend to numb myself with food and disconnect from being present. And so this is a opportunity for me to try to break that pattern, try something new. Also in terms of, I'm just noticing maybe two people are viewing. I have no idea if this is working. Send me a comment if you can hear me. Thanks. And white supremacy culture is the worst. And that's what, to me, Thanksgiving is based in. White supremacy culture of like colonialism. So there's like modern colonialism, which is domination culture, which is like when Europe dominated the Americas and owned them and implemented our languages and our cultures. So that happened, and we're still living in that era. And like in Colorado, Colorado's only been a state for like 150 years or something. So 160, 70 years. So that's not that long. That's like three generations. It's like, yeah, maybe four, I don't know. So yeah, so we're living in colonial times. But what I have noticed is that when it comes to abuse and domination culture, it's a trickle-down effect, right? It's kind of a big hierarchy of like who's on top. And a podcast I was listening to called it Christian Hegemony. And that was really enlightening because Europe had indigenous people as well. And those indigenous people were conquered by the Roman Catholic Church in the name of Rome and the Roman Empire. And so that's where Europeans learned to be colonizers because they were colonized. So it's kind of like a big domino effect, and like the most recent dominoes, I mean, they're still falling every day. This whole thing is in motion, but yeah, Christian hegemony is another layer back of when colonialism was taking over Europe. I think I've been thinking a lot about that because I've been noticing my own white supremacy culture in myself, and it comes up all the time. It's kind of like mansplaining, but just because of whiteness maybe in my mind. And yeah, I'm just weeding out this domination instinct. And it seems like an instinct, like it's everywhere in our culture. So yeah, watching Dune last night in the movie theater. Hey, three people, if you can hear me, let me hear it, because I have no idea if this is working. Send me a comment if you can. And Dune, watching Dune, and it's all about power dynamics and like the future and sci-fi, very complicated. A lot of different civilizations vying over planets and minerals, of course. But they're still in the paradigm of domination. And there's another paradigm of cooperation that I think is what the movie's about, is getting to. But man, it's almost ironic because you have these most beautiful actors we can find, and we like make them the kings of the future, except for the ugly ones, the monsters and such. Timothée Chalamet like is the future king, the savior, Christ figure, you know. His face just so chiseled. And yeah. So it's like, yeah, my thought during the movie was like, I'm really glad to live in the present political system because in the future shit's much more complicated. And still, it's just like the power controlled paradigm expanded into the future. It's a beautiful philosophical portrait. And someone. So, the question I was holding is, can we make that a cooperative paradigm? Or like, where's cooperation? And that seems to be the sand people, I don't know what they're called. But they seem to like go with the flow, and there was a little philosophical seed planting, and that is the way, as the Tao would say. So, go with the flow, and I guess that brings it back to Thanksgiving versus Thanksgiving, going with the flow. I lost the train a bit. Like, grounded in what's true and what's real. And what's true and what's real is not this story that we have in mass culture about everything being just and right and good. Like, we're good. We're the good guys. Yeah, let's be a little more honest about where we are and who we are in hopes that we can be better. Because when we're in denial, we're out of integrity with the truth. So, as a country, as a culture, we need to redefine who we are. We need to rediscover who we are. Hey, three viewers. Thanks for watching. So, yeah, rediscovering who we are as Americans, and, you know, we gotta reclaim these holidays. We can't just keep going with the status quo. That hope wraps it up. Christian Hegemony, look it up. All my relations podcasts where I heard that, look it up. And I think that's it for now. Implicit bias, you know. Yeah, I touched on how like the hegemony goes so deep in terms of what we value. You know, we inherit our values. I'm texting with a friend about having a conversation about this, about dominant values and things like aesthetics, right? Like whiteness as beauty. Timothy Chalamet as beauty. Like, why do we, David, the statue of David, you know, as beauty? Like, why do we, how and why do we hold up certain things as beautiful and good and other things as negative and bad? You know, where do we get those values? And how do we analyze them and see if they're just? Oh, and like, you know, biology and evolution and psychology, all these E's. Yeah, so those are some things to think about, I think, for me. I'm going to be listening to a lot of All My Relations podcast during Thanksgiving and just being present, just trying to be present as much as I can. And I wish you the same. That's the end of this live. Thanks for watching, y'all. See ya.